Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. During his State of the Union address January 20th, President Obama emphasized the importance of science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM, to maintaining a strong and competitive American economy.
I want Americans to win the race for the kinds of discoveries that unleash new jobs. Pushing out into the solar system, not just to visit, but to stay.
On hand as an invited guest was NASA astronaut Scott Kelly.
And in 2 months, to prepare us for those missions, Scott Kelly will begin a year-long stay in space. So good luck, Captain. Make sure to Instagram it.
The president acknowledged how this and other NASA research and technology efforts are preparing the United States for deep space travel and returning benefits to humanity. The next day, NASA helped highlight and expand on the STEM messages from the president's address during the White House's third annual State of STEM event. During the event, NASA Administrator Charlie Bolden, White House officials, and middle and high school students discussed research happening on the space station as part of an in-flight event with NASA astronauts. NASA Chief Scientist Ellen Stofan also participated in a panel discussion of women and girls in STEM fields. Also on January 21st, NASA's Technology Transfer Program released the 2015 edition of its annual Spinoff publication. Published every year since 1976, Spinoff highlights NASA initiatives that have resulted in technologies with commercial and societal benefits across the economy. To request free copies or download digital versions, go to spinoff.nasa.gov. New software by NASA and Microsoft announced on January 21st called OnSight will use the company's HoloLens device to allow scientists to see objects on Mars in 3D and perform virtual work on the Martian surface. Developed by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, OnSight, which uses real data from the Mars Curiosity rover, will let researchers examine the rover's work site almost as if they were standing on the red planet right beside it. Investigators around the world will be able to meet in a 3D simulation of the Martian environment and preview the results of their work firsthand. New images taken by NASA's Dawn spacecraft as it closes in on the dwarf planet Ceres are almost three times more detailed than calibration images taken in early December. Over the next several weeks, Dawn will deliver increasingly better images leading up to the spacecraft's capture into orbit around Ceres on March 6th. Dawn's arrival at Ceres for a 16-month study will mark the first time a spacecraft has ever visited a dwarf planet. NASA's Space Communications and Navigation, or SCAN, program hosted a workshop recently at NASA headquarters to review and assess emerging space navigation and communications technology for possible use on future missions and identify any potential knowledge and/or capability gaps that exist. The SCAN program is part of NASA's Human Exploration and Operations Mission Directorate. The 2014 Zero Robotics Championship recently took place aboard the International Space Station. The competition allows students to program robots aboard the ISS, known as Spheres, to solve a challenge in microgravity, with station astronauts helping to conduct the championship. It's also a unique and valuable opportunity to promote student interest in science, technology, engineering, and math careers. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.